Hi friends, today in this session we are going to discuss about this chapters, that is biomolecules. Biomolecules is one of the important chapter for IIT JEE as well as CBSE and NEET examinations. Let us see. Biomolecules are basically building blocks of monomers. We'll see which are these monomers. Monomers are the repeating unit as you have studied in junior classes. What is biomolecules? Actually, these are organic compound which is present as essential constituent of living organisms in different cells. Cells we have different cells like eukaryotes, prokaryotes, and these cells, these molecules are or you can say constituents are responsible for growth, maintenance and their ability to reproduce. So these are very important. So we are not going too much in details of biology terms. Living cells, these constituents are composed of basically carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. These are the main constituents, nitrogen, phosphorus and sulfur. CHO, these are present in large quantity in human body. Or you can say in short, like they constitute 70% mass of cell. Means in the whole cell, the 70% mass is present only CHO and PS. But we have to focus more about the molecules. Two molecules, one is small molecules, second is macromolecules. So we have to focus on macromolecules. Small molecules means they have low molecular mass, while the macromolecules means they have high molecular mass. So these macromolecules is again divided in two part. One is your carbohydrate, proteins and nucleic acid, and other part is called as lipid, vitamins and hormones. So let us see carbohydrates. What is carbohydrates? So these are saccharides, or you can say are called sugars. So interchangeably, both names are used for the carbohydrates. So these carbohydrates are defined as optically active. So these compounds are optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes. Means they have poly means they have so many OH groups, aldehydes or ketones. One ketones or aldehydes may be possible. Or in other words, you can say these compounds which produce such units means the unit means unit having the polyhydroxyaldehyde ketones on hydrolysis. So general formula is here CXH2O whole Y. Okay, so this is the formula for starch, and if you give acidic hydrolysis, it will convert into glucose. And this for sucrose. Sucrose, if you hydrolyze, it will convert into glucose plus fructose. So carbohydrates is not necessarily called as the hydrates of carbon, as it look like. You can see this hydrates of carbon. But X is not right to say. Why? Because if you take N equal to 1 for this compound, it becomes a formaldehyde. And you know, formaldehyde is not a carbohydrate. Well, if you take N equal to 2, it becomes C2H2O2. So it becomes your acetic acid. So these are not carbohydrates. So it is not necessary CH2OY. So all X and Y will be always equal, or is it same formula? Let us take one more example. So this compound is your rhamnose. You can see C6H12O5. So here oxygen is 5. So this compound is not satisfying the formula. So this is carbohydrate, but not satisfying the formula. So actual definition is for carbohydrate is optically active polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketones, or such compounds which produce these compounds on hydrolysis. Properties, carbohydrates are white solids. They are very sparingly soluble in organic solvents, very less solubles, except some polysaccharides, and very highly soluble in waters. Why it is soluble in water? Because they have hydrogen bonding with the OH hydroxy groups. Now we'll see the different type of classification of carbohydrates. If you take the basis of functional group, there are two types. One is polyhydroxyaldehydics, or second is polyhydroxyketone. So polyhydroxyaldehyde is your glucose, while if you take ketonic, it becomes your fructose. This is the one classification. Second, you can take on basis of reducing sugar. So there are two types of reducing sugar. One is the reducing natures. So there are two types of sugar. One is reducing sugar. Second is non-reducing sugar. These two different types. Reducing sugars are fructose, glucose, maltose, lactose, all monosaccharides. You can say all monosaccharides, or these are the reducing sugars. And why they are called reducing sugars? Because their monosaccharides has a free hemiacetal unit. So you have studied in your aldehyde chapters that what is hemiacetal. So they have hemiacetal units, and such unit is absent in case of non-reducing sugars. Okay, they don't have hemiacetal group, that's why it is called as non-reducing sugars. We have sucrose and all polysaccharides. This is one classification. And if you take the on basis of sweetness, we can divide the classification. One is sugar, second is non-sugars. This on basis of sweetness. Sweetness itself means saccharides. Okay. And one more classification on basis of number of carbon atoms, like 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, we can also divide. So we can divide in two types. One is aldose, aldopentose, and second is ketopentose. Aldopentose means they have CH group, and ketopentose means they have keto groups. If C is 4 or C is 5, we can say tetraaldopentose. If C is 5, we can say it is a pentoketohexose. So we'll see all these divisions. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 3 means trisugar. 4 means tetrose, 5 is pentose, 6 means hexose sugar, same means heptose sugar. This is your heptose. On basis of number of product of hydrolysis, so again these are two types, one is sugar, non-sugar. And sugar is again, we have two types, monosaccharides and oligosaccharides. What is monosaccharides? So monosaccharides cannot be hydrolyzed, they are simple sugars, while the oligosaccharides can be hydrolyzed up to 2 to 10 units. The units can be same or different monosaccharides. While the non-sugars are the polysaccharides, they are polymers, and their monomers are more than 10 units. Means if it is more than 10 units, it becomes a polysaccharide. What is monosaccharides? Again, we have seen the number of carbon divisions. So if you take the 3 carbon, 4 carbon, 5 carbon, 3 to 7 carbons are there. And again, divide into two types, aldose and ketose. So for aldose, if 3 carbons are present, it is called as aldotriose or ketotriose. Example, you can see this is glyceraldehyde dihydroxyacetone for ketonic sugar. 4 carbon aldotetrose, this is called as ketotetrose. So for aldotetrose, erythrose and threose. And for ketotriose, erythrulose. So it is a one is erythrose and erythrulose. Aldopentose, we have xylose, ribose, arabinose. And for ketopentose, ribulose and xylulose. Aldohexose, so aldehyde hexose, glucose, galactose. Here we have ketohexose, fructose and sorbose. Aldoheptose, ceduheptulose. And ketoheptose, it is manoheptulose. So there are almost 20 types of monosaccharides. So remember, there are 20 types of almost monosaccharides. These are some of the examples. And under the heading of this polysaccharides, okay, so there are two types of polysaccharides. One is homopolysaccharides, next is heteropolysaccharides. Heteropolysaccharides are again agar-agar, pectin, mucilage. Homopolysaccharides are starch and cellulose. And again in oligosaccharides, we have 2 to 10 units. So if unit is 2, it is called as disaccharide. If unit is 3, it is called as trisaccharides. Disaccharides is called double sugar, so sucrose, maltose and lactose. These are the examples. While for raffinose, so if you do hydrolysis, trisaccharides, so we'll get 3 different types of sugars, glucose, fructose and galactose under acidic hydrolysis. Similarly, for acidic hydrolysis of tetrasaccharides, that is tycose, so on acidic hydrolysis, it will convert to glucose, fructose and 2 molecules of galactose. Like that, disaccharide, tri, tetra, and we have 10. This is a 10 saccharide units, which can be same or different. That is called as decasaccharides. Reducing sugars, already we discussed these carbohydrates, which can reduce tolerance reagent to black PPT of silver. And Fehling solutions, so Fehling solutions also converted. But silver is giving this, and which are the reducing sugars? So these are the monosaccharides, maltose and lactose. All these are reducing sugars. While the non-reducing sugars, they does not reduce the tolerance reagent or Fehling solutions. For example, we have sucrose and all polysaccharides. And on basis of number of isomers, so again we have 3 carbon, 4 carbon, 5 carbon, 6 carbon. So in 3 carbon, we have two things. One is how many chiral carbons are present and what is the number of isomers for this triose carbon. So if you take aldehyde groups, it has one chiral carbon and isomers will be 2, because you have to use the formula 2 to the power n. So if n is equal to 1, you will get 2 isomers. For ketos, there is no such isomers are there. For 4 carbon, you can take 2 and power is again 1. So it will be your, power is with 2, because their chiral carbon is 2. This is the power. This is all these are n values. So n equal to 1, so you will get the 2. If n equal to 2, you get the 4. If n equal to 3, you will get the 8. And if n equal to 4, you will get the 16. 16 isomers in aldehydic monosaccharides are there. And for ketos, if you take 3, we get 8. For keto, 5 carbon, 2, 4. So although hexose is existing 16 optically active isomers, they have different type of enantiomers plus and minus. We will see all these things in details. Thank you very much.